الذين آمنوا الذين قالوا إنا نصارى.
This is a verse in the Quran. No, but I don't know where it's passing the Quran. It's 100% the Quran.
Okay.
It says 100%.
For most people.
Are you sure it's not 99%? Show
100%.
Me the Quran. Okay, show me that.
Brother, who knows that verse? I don't have the Quran on me, so I don't know what verse it is. But everyone who's watching should know the verse. And if it's not there, then I'll give you £1 million.
Cash. So, okay, so what you're saying, what your claim is, you're supposed to respect Christians.
No, no. What I'm saying is that the Christian people are the closest people to the believers, not to the hypocrites, not to the pagans, not to the fakes. Let's just then أقرب الناس مودة love and respect. للذين آمنوا الذين قالوا إنا نصارى.
Can we read it?
I'm
reading
it from the Quran. Yeah, we can read it from the Quran.
Where, please?
You know that verse? Okay.
I've got all the 114 chapters here.
Okay.
Where is it?
It's in the same verse. It's in the same verse that where it says you will find that the Jews are the most people that hate the believers.
You're making a claim.
No, no, I know. It's in the same verse. But it's there.
There's 114 chapters.
Which verse?
Which verse is it? Okay. Have you got internet?
Yeah.
Okay. Just go on the internet. Right. The verse which says Christians are closest to Muslims.
Can I read the verse while he's reading from there?
No problem, actually.
He's gonna read it first.
Surah 98, ayah 6.
What do you think about this?
It says, verily, those who disbelieve in the religion of Islam, the Quran, and Prophet Muhammad, from among...
Come walk over there. There's your over there.
Yes, sir.
Just away from there, but
sorry.
Sorry. I'd like to thank you for your own. Surah
98 verse 6.
Surah 98 verse 6. Okay.
Oh, you saw it.
No, he's going to read it.
We're going to read this verse and he's by his final one using that. So he says, verily, those who disbelieve in the religion of Islam, the Quran, and the Prophet Muhammad, from among the people of the scripture, that Jesus and Mushrikeen, and our Mushrikeen will abide in a fire of hell. They are the worst of creatures. It's saying here that the scripture, the people of the scripture, the Jews and the Christians, they are the worst of creation.
Okay,
can you explain that to me?
A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. There are so many verses in the Quran which even say about the Jews and the Christians, at that time they will be in heaven, for example. But one second. There are so many verses which are saying that the people are our brothers, Christians. That are they are. But I wanted you, coming back to...
I can't find what
you're saying. Okay. You know that verse? Can you find what ayah that is in? Can you just check that? He's going to find you the ayah. Okay.
Love so, Christians.
No, no, no. Saying the most people to the... Because there's a difference between a Muslim and a believing Muslim. There's a difference between a hypocrite, a Muslim and a believing Muslim. A believer, we will always be loved by people. So the Muslim that is a believer, you can't hate this person, he will be loved. He's not ISIS or someone like that. They're not believers. These people are evil people. Do you understand?
No, ISIS are Muslims.
Okay, they're Muslims.
According to the Quran.
They're Muslims by name. Like there's someone
no,
like...
Even by action.
By action? No, no,
yeah,
no, 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 no.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The Prophet, he never...
According to your Quran, by action, they're Muslims.
What did ISIS do that the Quran doesn't teach?
Okay, here's the verse. 81, this is the verse that he wanted. This is Safha 121, verse 81. Let's see, then. What chapter is this?
Okay. There's no chapter 121.
Wait, no, it's the verse 121. So basically, Allah is saying the closest people. Sorry? Surat al-Ma'idah, what chapter is that? It's chapter 5, yeah? Okay, chapter 5. So Allah
subhanahu wa
ta'ala, verse 100 and where is it?
You went to chapter 5.
Wow. Oh, 81, yeah?
So 5.
Oh, 81.
81.
Yeah. Okay. So what Allah is saying here, you will say, he's saying that the most people that love the believers, the Muslim believers, are the people that call themselves Nasara, Christians. The reason why is because they have priests and they have religious holy people and they are not Arab.
You're not wrong.
Are you reading the Quran? Are you?
No, part 82. 82?
No, brother.
Okay. Said 81.
No. You said 81.
Is it 81? Yeah, 81 to 8, yeah, 81.
Okay, let me read 81, yes?
Okay.
And they believe...
82.
Is it 82?
It's only 82, yeah?
582.
Okay. Okay. Surely you will find the most hostile of the people towards the faithful to be the Jews and the polytheists.
Okay.
And surely you find the nearest of them in affection that are faithful to be those we are Christians.
Who call themselves Christians.
That is because they are priests, monks among them, and because they are not arrogant.
Okay.
Okay, wait. In the same chapter, verse 51, it says you're not supposed to be friends with Jews and Christians.
No, okay, can I ask you?
So why is there a problem in the Quran?
Can I answer you that?
No, what is the context?
Okay, the context is, let me context this.
We're not supposed to be friends with Jews and Christians.
Awliya is a different, there's a political system. Awliya, they should not take them as like, how can I say?
That was the Jews.
Okay, he's saying we have to look at the time it came down, the political situation, what happened at that time for the verse to come down. But coming back to that verse, what I was gonna say is that the believing Christians, look at Syria and Iraq. Who protected the Christian woman from ISIS being raped? It was the Iraqi army. Wait, one second.
You're giving a preach here. We don't want to preach here. We just want to just we don't want to be talking about each other. Yeah?
Okay? Shia and Christian. Right, okay. Muslim and Christian. The Muslim believers and the Christians. I'm just Muslim, but the family of the Prophet Abraham, the family of Abraham have been abandoned. That's why Islam is a mess. The family of Abraham, Isaac and Ishmael. Well, the Prophet Muhammad was from Ishmael.
Okay, we understand.
That's why you find ISIS.
Sir,
that's why you find scumbags.
We're asking you.
Yeah.
You show us this verse. Yeah.
Yeah.
Why is there a verse in the same chapter that says, do not be friends with Jews and Christians?
Okay, it never said do not be friends with them. Because here it's saying that they are the most loved with the Muslims, the Christians. It's saying, do not take them as awliya. Awliya in the Arabic Thesaurus, if you look at it, and at that time when it came down, we have to look at that. But I just wanted to say, we have to look at the content. We have to look at the time it came down, and what was the political situation. No, it never said friends.
Wait, let me read it. All you who have faith, do not take Jews and Christians for friends. They are friends of each other. Any of you who befriends them is indeed one of them. Indeed, Allah does not guide the wrong.
You're reading an English translation. You're reading a different translation. Okay, right. The translation. Awliya does not mean friends. Awliya is a different word. It's like on that time, but like I said,
allies means friends.
But brother,
what does ally mean?
No.
Okay. You say in UK, our allies, are they friends?
That's what it means.
See, what you're doing is hold on one second.
Yeah.
You have numerous scholars who translate this as friends, okay?
Okay.
Numerous scholars, right?
How many scholars?
Now what you're doing,
yeah?
What you're doing is you're saying, I know better than the scholars.
No.
That's what you're saying. So you're saying,
but you're telling me numerous scholars have said this friends.
It says it here, yeah.
Okay,
clearly.
So it says it from here.
That's, you
know there's 72 different sects in Islam, isn't it? There's 72 different sects in Islam. So one of them is
the
tafsir is different. But what I wanted to say, because Matthew, for example, we respect Matthew, respect Peter, these are disciples of Jesus. That's why we say Muhammad, peace be upon him, who's the cousin of Jesus, had 12 disciples, just like Jesus had 12 disciples, and they were all from the descendants of Abraham. But the problem with Muslims today is that they killed these disciples and rejected these disciples. That's why we've got bloodshed and fitna in this ummah, and that's why Islam is weak. But there is people who still follow these disciples, who still follow the bloodline of Abraham, who still follow the correct Islam. And like I said, the Christianity was correct at that time. Jesus did raise the dead. He did cure the blind with the power of Allah. So, but after he went, the Jews tried to kill him. Allah saved him. He sent Angel Gabriel. Angel Gabriel's lifted him up with his wing, and he took Jesus to heaven. The Jews said, we must kill Jesus. Jesus will come back very soon, and when he comes back, he will break the cross. And when he breaks the cross, he will kill the swine. And every Christian that is sincere to God will become Muslim and follow Jesus. And
okay,
Jesus.
What you're saying is
if you don't know this, even a rabbi in Israel has said before he died, I don't know, you can
fail. Coming to judge you, sir.
No, but did
coming to judge you, we know.
Do you agree that there was a rabbi in Israel who before he died, he said Jesus is coming back very soon?
No,
do you agree on that?
No,
we don't know that story.
I'm just saying.
We don't know who he is.
Okay. I'm just saying.
Well, okay, have you seen? Okay. We've heard you.
Okay.
You've been getting it for quite a while. What
you're saying is emotional rant.
It's not emotional
rant. Wait.
It's historical fact.
You can't control your emotions.
Godwin read to you Sura 98, verse 6.
Yeah.
Jews and Christians are the worst of creatures.
Who said that?
Your Allah. Quran, Surah 98, verse 6.
Hold on, just wait a minute.
Surah 98, verse 6.
No, no, but which interpretation does it say that?
Ask someone else. How many interpretations are there?
Oh, so now you're asking how many interpretations?
No, why are you asking me?
Should I tell you how many
interpretations?
Should I tell you how many interpretations there are? Regarding the Muslims, right now, Muslims are doing paganism because they don't know how to interpret the verse themselves. Some Muslims say, Allah, one second.
Because you're uncomfortable with the verses,
brother,
you say this is wrong.
So a lot of Muslims,
let's read it,
a lot of Muslims say Allah's got two right hands, like they made him like a Hindu god. And these Muslims were against these Muslims. We say this is haram.
Read
the
Arabic.
Min ahli al-kitab wal mushrikin. It's not saying
wal mushrikin
fi nari jahannam khalidan fiha ulaikum sharr al-bariya. The ones that were people of the book at the time of Jesus, that kufr in Jesus at that time, because they never followed Jesus 100%. A lot of people went against Jesus.
No, they died on the cross.
Who ordered to kill Jesus? The Jews, right or wrong? Sir. Tell me I'm wrong.
Okay, but that's not the point.
No, what do you mean?
You're beside the point.
So those people that tried to kill Jesus, are they good people?
Brother, and they're Jews.
Yeah. Are they good people? Answer my question.
Why doesn't he answer my question? Yeah. You're being very emotional.
I'm not being emotional. You're trying to say...
One thing is, calm down.
Okay.
Take a breath.
Okay.
Calm down. We want to be able to have a conversation.
Breathe out.
Okay. What we're trying to understand.
Okay.
Yes? In the surah, my brother Daniel just read the surah 5,
okay?
Where it states that you should not make friends with the Jews.
Let me finish. He's my friend. He can be my friend. The Quran doesn't say that.
Surah 98, verse 6, it states clearly that Christians and Jews are the worst of creation. Okay?
Okay,
Let me finish.
Which Jews are the ones that tried to kill Jesus? Yeah, they're the worst of creation. The Jews that tried to kill Jesus.
Where did it say that?
It says, in the ladina, kafaru min ahl al-kitab. The ones that did kufr from ahl al-kitab.
That's why you need to look at the
interpretation. You have to look at the interpretation.
I'm going
to
show you which Christians.
Listen, when the Holy Prophet Muhammad told the peace be upon him and his family, he said to the Muslims, go to Abyssinia, there's a Christian king. One second. What did the Christian king say to the Muslims? He said, the only difference between us and you is this line. That's it. There is no difference. Because we respect Mary. We respect Jesus.
No one said this.
We never said this. Have you seen the message?
All right, wait.
Have you seen the film? Right.
What do you think about Christians who believe Jesus is the Son of God?
The Christians that believe that Jesus is the Son of God are trying to say blasphemy. Why? So did God have sex? Did God have sex to have a son?
People who believe that Jesus
is exactly like Adam. Adam was created without a father. Jesus was created without a father. When Jesus comes back, he's gonna put all these points on you, and he's gonna say, "Look, does it now make sense?" And then you're gonna say yes. And then it's gonna be pretty.
So do you believe Christians who believe Jesus is the Son of God are the worst of creatures? Yes or no?
No, I don't believe this.
You don't believe that? Your Quran says that. Surah 930 says, the Jews say Israel is the son of Allah. Are you listening? And Christians say Christ is the son of Allah. This is an opinion that they mouth imitating. The opinions of the faithless of former times. May Allah destroy them. So you want Allah to destroy me?
No.
I believe
I've said,
this is the son of
Allah. You've read that.
You want Allah to destroy
you've
me?
You've read an English translation.
Read Arabic.
One second.
Read Arabic.
I have read it.
Hey, no, Surah 930, you haven't read it.
وَقَالَتُ الْيَهُودُ عَزِيزُ ابْنَ اللَّهِ وَقَالَتُ النَّصَارَى الْمَسِيحُ ابْنَ اللَّهِ ذَلِكَ قَوْلُهُمْ بِأَفْوَاهِهِمْ يُضَاهِئُونَ قَوْلَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ قَبْلُ قَاتَلَهُمُ اللَّهُ أَنَّى يُؤْفَكُونَ So,
have you ever read this before?
No, I have read it. But what
okay,
I'm saying,
so what is that saying?
It's saying what is after it, the verse after it.
You want to know the verse after it?
Yeah,
you give me the
problem.
Yeah.
Read it.
No problem. Okay. This is where they have taken their rabbis and their priests and their monks gods instead of God. And they did not. Where they were not told to worship the Jesus. They were told.
Wait, let me finish, man.
Yeah, I'm gonna give you something. Yeah, he never said God is son. He said Ibn Maryam.
Yeah, the son of Mary.
Wait, we're gonna expose that. Don't worry. Go.
So basically,
I believe Jesus is the son of God.
Yeah, but
so you're supposed to destroy me.
But Jesus will. Jesus will be upset with you. Right now, Jesus.
What did the Quran say?
Do you believe Jesus is watching?
What does the Quran say? What does the Quran say?
The Quran says
they have taken. No. They have taken their rabbis and priests as monks as gods instead of the one God.
But are you personally ignoring? It says those who believe. Go read the verse.
Well, you have to read the verse after it. It's explaining why.
You read 30.
He's explaining why.
Sir, you read 30 and then you read it that they have taken their scribes and their monks as gods besides Allah.
Okay.
So this English translation is okay, yeah?
No.
It's alright, yeah? According to the Arabic. Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. But Christ, Mary's son, though they were commanded to worship only the one God, there's no God except him, he is far too immaculate to have any partners that they ascribe to him. So we ascribe Jesus as God. So you want us to be destroyed, yes or no?
Basically,
according to the Quran.
Okay, what has happened is that God has said is that when they went and worshipped Jesus never told them to worship him. Jesus said, I have come, so you worship the one God. When Jesus did,
we worship Jesus. We worship Jesus.
Yeah, but that, okay.
Jesus
so,
doesn't have a problem.
So Jesus, you know Jesus.
No, I want you to answer the question.
Do you believe?
Should we? What does it say? Should, should we be destroyed?
I believe Jesus.
Should we be destroyed?
No.
So what is Allah?
Why is the Quran saying we should be destroyed?
No. What happened was the people at that time that made lies on Jesus and the monks that were making money or the Jews that wanted to kill Jesus, and they wrote in the books and they changed the books and they made it that people not worship God, and instead of worship the one God that created the whole world, they made them worship Jesus. Those people that did this crime, they will be punished by God, because God has told Jesus to tell the people to worship God alone. So when these people have done this crime, this is a big crime, and they should be punished. But you do not know, because you are following, obviously, your parents, and you're following
your parents. No, we're
following
the Bible. The Bible says to worship Jesus.
But the Bible is supposed to be given by Allah.
The Injil says worship Jesus.
But the problem with the Bible, when people, for their political reasons, try to put things in the Bible and change it, God sent the last prophet.
They didn't change it.
Okay, are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
So you're telling me
that
the Bible, from the time of Jesus, 2,000 years ago, till today, has not been changed by an inch or an atom?
Tell us where it has been.
Okay, so that's what you're telling me.
Give us the proof.
That's what you're saying. So they're saying that the Bible for 2,000 years has never been changed.
Yes. No. What did Allah Muhammad say about it? Did Allah Muhammad say it's been changed?
No, one second. Why did Allah send the last prophet Muhammad, who is the cousin of Jesus, to mankind? Because he said, I'm going to send the last book, which is the Quran, which has never been changed for 1,100 years. And he took him to Allah. Do you believe he's coming back? Do you believe Jesus is coming back?
He's coming back to judge the whole world.
When?
No. Those who don't believe.
When? Okay.
You're jumping.
I'm not jumping.
You're all over the place. The original question is this, okay? It's very clear, explicit throughout the Quran, like a drumbeat, yes?
Yeah.
Allah does not love the unbeliever. Allah says that Christians are the worst of Christians.
No.
Allah says...
Never said that.
We've read you...
What about the first?
We've read you...
What about that verse?
Baba,
Muslims the most.
Okay, let's just go with that for a minute.
You're contradicting yourself.
Are you saying that the Quran is contradicting itself?
No, you're contradicting.
Are you saying the Quran is contradicting itself? Are you saying the Quran is contradicting itself?
No, women.
So what would you say about all these verses that say destroy the Christians?
Exactly. Brother, when a verse comes down in the Quran, you have
to look
at it. Brother, you have to look at it. Listen, the problem with Muslims today, why is Islam messed up? Islam is messed up because Muslims, Muslims have taken the verse from the Quran and gave their own interpretation, and Islam is a mess today. It's
like a
mess. Because Muhammad and Jesus came for one message, and that is to worship one God. Abraham had two sons. Where did you get Abraham had two sons?
Jesus,
Ishmael and Isaac. This is Jesus. This is a revert from Christianity to Islam.
Are you going to ask him?
I'm just come to tell him not to deal with brothers that are experienced in the Bible, because I'm saying he doesn't have the experience. So you're being unfair. Listen, for the cameras, this brother's not experienced in debating Christians, right? He's definitely experienced in the Bible. So don't take any of this. They haven't won anything if they won, if it appears they won.
We're here to win. We're just give the truth.
I'm saying, I've known you lot for years.
Are you experienced in the Bible?
I am.
Can you answer our question?
Are you experienced?
Yeah, ask him.
He's a Christian, I mean.
Okay.
Can you answer our question? Less than 5 minutes, I really want to win, but go ahead.
Okay.
You said the Bible, yeah?
So the conversation started off. You can ask, it kind of bounced from different questions.
Okay.
But the original question was this, okay? We see over and over again, because this brother is saying to us that Christians and Muslims are friends, and you know, we're supposed to love each other, and we're this brotherhood. Do you agree with that, first of all? Because I don't want to go off his premise. Do you agree with that?
Like, I agree we should respect each other.
Yes.
Love each other based upon the connection of humanity and good character.
That's what you believe.
No, good character.
Okay. That's what he claims.
Right.
The Quran doesn't say that.
So, do you agree that the Quran doesn't say that?
I agree the Quran does say that.
Yes.
Where does the Quran say that?
Any specific verses? Okay, if you know me, I'm not. For the last however months, my whole thing has been a specific group of people. Yes?
The Sunni savage
monkey beast kafir dog. So therefore, when it comes to anything to do with answering you all from the Quran, I haven't got it in my forefront. Let me tell you, if you give me a verse, I mean, you know we're allowed to marry Christians, right? The men. Yes?
Yeah.
So I'm saying if I'm allowed to marry,
convert them to Islam, right?
Yeah, what I'm saying to you. You're saying to convert them. There's no guarantee that if I marry a Christian, that she's...
We have no problem.
Listen,
that's the issue we have.
Listen, what I'm saying. If I marry a Christian woman, that means our families, that Christian's family, her family, and my family become united, in particular upon our children, correct? In other words, if we marry and we don't have children, we can go our separate ways.
Right,
as soon as we have children, we're now connected by blood to descendants. Okay. So when you're saying about this hatred and so on, I'm saying there has to be some sort of mutual respect, care and love, because we now have children and grandchildren in common.
Show us where the Quran says that.
But you just agreed we can marry Christians.
No. That's your assertion.
So does that mean you just love women, you hate men?
No, I said family.
No.
Do you marry? Listen carefully.
You don't marry men. Don't say it again.
So we're talking about men and women. Listen carefully.
We have listened.
What you're trying to do is you're trying to use a logical trail.
What I'm saying to you is that it doesn't follow with the Quran. When you read the Quran, it doesn't follow what you are trying to reason with.
I totally agree with you. I'm saying to you that let's see if the verses you quote are in context. That's what I have to see.
You want the verses?
Yes.
Yeah. Generally, I know
Sura 98, verse 6.
Do you know it?
Go ahead.
I know, like I said, always at the forefront of my head are all the verses I need for the Sunni savage monkey beast. Don't trust the Sunni. Wherever you are, don't trust the Sunni. They do not ever represent Islam. Never forget that.
Why would you say like that?
Shia!
No,
Shia!
No,
Shia! Before you go,
before you go there,
debate me on the Qur'an, I'll prove they don't believe in the Qur'an.
They don't believe Islam.
You believe the Qur'an?
Yes.
You believe the Qur'an?
Yes.
Let me read the Qur'an.
Oh, he does.
He doesn't believe the Qur'an.
Okay.
So, anyway, let's get back to
it. Okay, let me read it.
Indeed, the faithless from among the people of the book and the polytheists
the faithless.
Will be... Yeah.
The faithless, from among the people of the book.
Will be in hellfire to remain in it forever. It is they who are the worst of creatures.
Okay.
So that includes me and a Jew as the worst of creature in the Quran.
Indeed, the faithless... No. From among...
Am I faithless?
Stop. From among. Is that all of them or is that from them?
From among the people.
Okay, so what about those who are not faithless?
Yeah, tell me who are not faithless. Stop.
I'm just saying, the translation you've produced, okay, says indeed the faithless from among the people of the book and the polytheists. So therefore, if you have a whole group of 100 and you've got 5 who are faithless, that is not talking about the 95.
You're right.
You understand?
Am I faithless?
You see? Don't run behind that. Just dialogue. Yeah, don't divert.
Godwin and I, are we faithless?
No.
You've got faith.
You're a Christian who believes Jesus is God. Am I faithless? Yes or no?
The translation, no.
I'm not.
I'm saying according to the verse translation you've produced. Yes?
Specifically.
Let me give you
one word.
That's what I'm going to explain.
Right? You're a Sunni, he's a Shia.
Number one. Number two, he's not really. didn't say that, correct?
But it's in brackets.
Right. What I'm saying to you is, I'm more now convinced of what I was saying. Yeah? But let me see the verse before. No, no, that's fine. No, I'm saying I like to...
You don't take even Kathir, even... You don't take them, do you?
Bro, I need to see, man. Come on, I can't even... Go on, I'm trying to concentrate.
I'm trying to show you tough stuff.
What's the verse before? And they were commanded not to...
It's all about worship and Allah.
No, who is it? Who is it?
It's all about worship and Allah.
Bro, you're not getting it. The problem that I have is the words from among. That's my whole point to you is, when they talk about the faith that's from among, as soon as you get the words
you
from
made
among,
that point over and over
right,
again.
So you can't,
over
from again. Among is not all, that's what I'm saying.
What I'm saying
we understand.
Who identify that? Who that is.
Listen carefully.
Who
all
are
right,
they?
Right.
Who are they?
Let's say a Christian who commits certain crimes and acts and doesn't really care, but he just goes by the name Christian. Do you understand that?
But does it say that there?
Have you said the faithless among
but,
them?
But, okay.
Well,
do you know what Christian is?
According to the Quran, those who believe... Wait. According to the Quran, those who believe Jesus is the son of Allah, they are not faithful. They're faithless. Surah 930.
I agree with you, but I'm saying the context, even what you said.
Right, but so what we're asking our Muslim friends, yeah, is we're saying.
Yeah, Muslim friends, you're talking to me.
To you as well, okay? We're saying that we do not believe.
I was going to get to that actually.
Okay.
No, I was going to get to that. No. You see what he just said? I was thinking. There's a verse that says,
"Who is it? The Jews, the Christians, the Samaritans,
and all who believe in Allah on the last day, they've got a promise with the Lord." Do you know that last day?
Sorry?
We're talking about those who believe, the Jews, the Christians, and Sabians, they will have the reward with it, and they believe in Allah on the last day, they will have the reward. You know about that verse? Because the Sunnis say it's been abrogated.
Maybe, I don't know.
But I'm saying the context is, this is why I said I would have to see the context, but even more so, I feel...
But your context is not helping. Because what
you say it's wrong. All right, give me the opposite then. Is it all of them?
Okay, you said Christians that make crime.
No. I'm saying
doesn't explain that. No, that's not theology.
Problem. Listen carefully.
When I say crime,
what I mean is, they don't care. Like, they go by the name Christians, but they actually don't care about being holy or righteous. Okay. So you understand? For instance, Catholic priests, they go by the name Christians. But behind the scene, they're raping little boys to get away with.
Okay, yeah.
Perfect example. There you go. That's what I'm talking about.
Okay, but what about me?
Right, so I'm saying,
what about
you would
me?
Be,
I'm talking about
from
me.
From what I've seen with you, this would refer, you're a faithful Christian.
Faithful Christian.
Faithful.
Even though if I believe Jesus is God.
And I believe Muhammad is
God. In other words, your effort, meaning, you're deceived. Yeah, I'm just saying. Yeah? So you're deceived and deluded. You don't know what the truth is, but you actually believe in this thing to be true. There are people that actually don't care about God, don't care about this, but they dress in the robes and they abuse little boys. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So they are definitely faithless.
True?
Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no? You're saying they're faithful.
Listen to what we're saying.
No, yes
they are faithless, but that doesn't answer the question.
That doesn't answer the question.
Because that's not the only thing that describes faithlessness.
Oh,
if I believe Jesus is God, I am faithless and not a Muslim.
No, listen to what I'm saying. That's why I said context. I'm saying this.
We're giving you the context.
There's a command.
No, you're waffling now. Wait, hold on. No, you spoke for a while. You spoke for a while. Yes, you did. You spoke for a while. Let us respond to what you're saying, right? Okay? Now, we're giving you a verse, and we're asking specifics. We're not asking around about, okay? Right, now, Christians believe that Jesus Christ is God.
Yes.
Christians believe that Muhammad is a false prophet.
Yes.
Christians believe that Jesus died and rose again.
We have faith in that, yes?
Christians, we believe all these things. Christians do not believe Allah is God. Christians believe the Quran is false. Christians believe that the Quran has contradictions. And so, over and over again, these are the things. Now, would you say, we believe in the Trinity? We believe in
all Okay, let's say you're faithless. Now what?
We're faithless.
Yeah,
okay.
Let's go with it.
Right. So are we the worst creatures?
According to the Quran. Okay, let's say yes.
Yes. Now, thank you.
Is that
right. So that was what we wanted to.
Among.
Yes.
What the hell do you want? You want me to take the words from among out?
Right,
this is what I'm saying. I'm never
let's read. Let me.
The
let
problem
me
is they've been discussing with Sunni savage monkey bees so long, their brains have been contaminated by the Sunni savage monkey bees. I wear the mask. I wear this mask to protect me from being contaminated. Wear a mask. Yeah, trust me. Wear some.
So,
one incident.
What you done? You've gone around about.
Where did it say from? Where did it say from? Where did it say from?
Roundabout way. It's your Quran that contradicts itself.
Okay.
We didn't make your Quran. Your Quran makes no sense.
Oh, is your point it's a contradiction? Is that what you're saying?
No, that's
what
and also to prove that the Quran says when
worst.
Okay.
Of creatures.
You know okay, so you're saying it doesn't mean from, it means all. Yes?
Those who believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, yes, those are faithless.
When it says from, the faithless from above.
Can I answer that? Can I answer that?
So what about the other people who are not faithless? Who are in
who
the
people? Who are they? Who are these people?
We don't know.
This
doesn't
make no sense.
The personality of the faithlessness, what is it?
Who are the Christians that don't believe Jesus is God? Who are the Christians that don't believe Jesus is God?
To judge the people of the book, judge the Christians by their book, and judge the Jews, or let the Jews judge themselves by the... Yes, do you know that
verse? Specific question.
Right, so I'm saying, there are, for instance, in the Qur'an, you agree in the Qur'an,
specific time.
You agree in the Qur'an,
no, there isn't.
You agree in the Qur'an, you have a different level than the polytheists in Germany, yes?
Yeah, of course.
I'm saying you call the people of the book.
Yeah, yeah.
So you, yeah, compared
record,
to the polytheists,
you want to record them?
You have a higher level towards us. Right. So I'm saying to you, there is some other way of looking at you than you're trying to portray, like you're just, you know, even if it, the fact that it says from among them, and even the verse says from the polytheists. That's what I'm saying to you.
The polytheists are involved.
It says from, I don't know what you want me to do.
Okay, let me read it.
I've been there more than 10 minutes, bro. Let me read it.
What is the meaning you said of that verse?
Which one? So, alright, so when you say faithless, it means disbelief. Yeah, when it says faithless, it's
awful. So you agree with us? So you agree with us?
You agree with us?
You agree with us? The Quran says that.
No, 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 I'm saying that's a different verse, isn't it? Do you get me?
That's sort of, that's the verse. I'm trying to show you who are
faithless.
And they're supposed to be not friends with us according to Surah 95, Surah 98 verse 6, where the worst of creatures, because we believe Jesus is the Son of God. For example, Surah 930, we believe that we are faithless. So what? That's what the Quran says. The Quran has no love for unbelievers. However, the Bible says, love your enemies. Not just the faithless, love your enemies, pray for those who despitefully use you and persecute you. So today we're showing that the Quran has a low moral standard compared to the Bible. Come to Jesus, who can save you.